All right, welcome everyone, Resemblance of Sanity. I'm Caleb.
I'm Jacob.
And we're here for
Nana, episode 33.
All right, fucking Takumi.
I am already sick to my stomach.
Long black hair, shades inside looking ass.
Like, this isn't an I am dead inside. This is like a... Like, you know, the Bolton's way of doing things is starting to sound pretty good. You
know,
like,
it's the kind of thing where I have a like a long list of anime characters that I'm like, I love to hate you.
Yeah.
But there's a really short list of characters. I'm like, I hate that you just exist.
Right. Like exactly. It's the I so despise you. But it very much doesn't go into I don't like that you're in the show,
right?
You know?
Right.
But it's like, but I don't even like to hate you, right?
I hate you, yeah,
right?
Yeah, like, exactly.
Like, and not like an idle dislike hate, you know, like an active burning
loathing,
you know.
Yeah, there's something to be said for when a character can be built up properly to be a shitty person.
Mm-hmm.
That then when they actively do the shitty thing that you've been building up to, you're then still surprised to level in which they go, even though you built up to it properly. A lot of dramas will sometimes make the character suddenly reveal their nastiness, and it's, oh, Anna, if only there was someone who loved you.
Right,
and
it's like, wait, where the fuck did that come from?
There's like, you know, one eyebrow raise of buildup worth for it. Whereas in other things, it's the no. We had a exponential buildup, but even then, you know, the Takumi stocks in terms of hate level went up so high in a single day that it's like,
yeah,
I didn't think that was legal. Like,
and the fact that this is a grounded show, right?
Yes.
Even though everything that happens is very dramatic,
yes,
it's very real. This is a violation in a way that you don't get in, you know, any kind of fantastical story where you have some, like, war crime against humanity kind of a thing happen,
right? Because in a lot of ways in those stories, we have to go for something that's more akin to it being less subtle. It's something that is, like...
shocking and disturbing.
Yeah, it's someone getting, you know, disemboweled in terms of the subtlety.
Right.
Whereas this is the, like, no. Mm-hmm. His words are
it's like a bamboo
nasty
shoot
little vice claws that are disemboweling our main character.
Just slowly pushing a bamboo shoot under the fingernails.
Yeah.
You know, right? Like it's... Yeah.
Yeah. But, okay. Nobuo, he stayed by the bedside. Wonderful.
Good. Awesome.
Yasu now knows a little bit about the situation.
He
That's
did
good.
The brow furrow, which
Nana ran
me
away.
Hopeful.
But that means she might end up talking to Ren. We'll see. We have... everyone have a nice potential domino effect of things being passed around.
Do you know what is the thing that could make me most happy if this episode started with it? Even more than opening with Yasu.
Okay.
Opening with Junko.
Oh. See, here's the thing, though. Do you think that Junko and Kyosuke actually have the full capacity to be as empathetic as possible in this situation? I don't think they do.
Maybe not. You know,
I think they're a bit too.
Their relationship has definitely like grown more distant. So they, you know,
right.
In addition to personal flaws,
right. But
know,
I also think in terms of the way that they talk about Hachi when she's not there, it would be
maybe they wouldn't be the best.
Well, they wouldn't be the best immediately. I think what they'd need to be is they need to be that like third person.
Mm.
You know, if Nobuo's first, okay, then we need like.
Yasu is second.
Well, no, then we need just like the band as a group.
Sure.
Even if Nana's not there, even if, whatever. We need we need the group, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then I'd take, you know, Kyosuke and Junko to then be like the, what the fuck, Nana? What's going on? Why didn't you tell us? Oh my God.
And then they
do the panic for her kind of thing, but then they dive in and hug.
Yeah,
hold,
yeah, group hug and. Mm-hmm.
And then maybe, you know, maybe they yell at her a bit after, you know, but.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll take what I can get right now, you know. But y'all, without further ado, let's get into this. Okay, there it is. There it is.
Oh, all right.
The debut. Cool. Let's use the animation from the first OP. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Naoki stocks are the highest they've ever been. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, sorry, ne, sagashikutte.
Yes. Oh,
that was. Yes, fantastic.
Dosta.
Yes, kaeru ne, ore.
Na, wari na.
Ya, zenzen. Ojama shimashita.
Very tasteful, mm-hmm. Just I'm gonna make my exit. Door's locked, dumb fuck. I mean, I guess they're just so distraught, you know. Ah, they did.
Nice.
Cool.
Nice. Good move.
Hey, fuck you, fuck you.
This is very satisfying.
Bro. Don't even like.
Bibirasanna yo mo delicate datte itteru no ni. Tsuka, Nobu.
Is man about to pull like a Sherlock and like try and like solve?
I don't know, but I want to see him squirm.
Oh. She left her phone here. She doesn't want to talk to anybody. Or at least nobody else.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck out of here. Wait, he did leave?
Oh. I was thinking that they just left together, but...
Nope, guess not.
Okay.
Oh! Oh. Okay! Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Yep. Yeah.
All right. Okay.
Hmm. Oh. Okay.
Okay.
Oh.
Are we going back onto the good timeline this quickly?
Yeah.
甘いブラックストーンの香りに包まれていると 不思議なほど安らいでいくのを自覚した。
To her, it's a sweet smell. Like the super strong.
ね、京介。
いや、ヘキ、つうか、ダメだね、男ってのは。こういう時オロオロするばっかりで。
ただオロオロしてどうすんのよ。
いや、そうなんだけどね。なんか肩身が狭いのよ。
He cares about her, he just...
話に聞く限りは、妙に潔い決断力で。
自己中で威圧的な男としか思えないけど。
そうか？
だって、ナナの携帯使っていきなりノブにそんな話したら、ノブが疑心暗鬼になってひるむのは当たり前じゃん。戦意喪失させて引き下がり。
いや、いや、うん、いや、
う
ん。
もうナナが抵抗できないように部屋に鍵をかけて。
いや、い
や、本当にナナを思いやってたらそんなや。
Yeah, no, he's a piece of shit.
そこまで深く考えてないよきっと。私がノブのこと彼氏とか言ったりしたから、きっと単に悔し紛れの勢いで。
あらそう、ごちそうさま。
いや、なんかプライドが高い人だから。
高いのかそれ。それが本音だとしたら、おもちゃ取られた子供の。
Hey, there you go, Kyosuke.
ま、何にしても子供を認知するなんて生半可な気持ちじゃ言えないって。
Serious about it right now, at least.
経済力はあるの？何してる人？
ミュージシャン。
大丈夫なのそれ？稼ぎあんの？なんで黙んのよ。
まあ迷わず認知するっていうくらいだから。それなりにある。
He's super famous.
インチって言い方が気に食わない。
Yeah, yeah.
教育費だけ出すみたいな。
でもそういう意味だと思う。
な。何それ？なんで結婚してくんないの？妻子持ち？またもや不倫？
うん。でも結婚となるといろいろ大変だろうし、そこまで迷惑かけられないよ。
意味わかんないよ。
Forget impose. What do you even want?
十分だよ。
何産みたいんだ。
最初はね、気のせいであってほしいと思う。
Here we go, here we go。
あんまり考えないようにして逃げてたし、でも思い当たることはあったから不安になって。
Yeah, yeah。
ほら、検査薬で陽性が出た時も逃げ場がなくなったみたいで怖かったけど、本当に妊娠してるなら早く。
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
病院で本当に自分の子供がお腹にいるんだって分かって、急に実感みたいのが湧いて。
Oh. Damn, and his words were also pull yourself together.
Yeah.
Ah! Maternal instinct.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Yeah, yeah, oh. Yeah, yeah,、
mm-hmm.
yeah.
It's, if you're going based on proof, then the relationship's done anyways.
Yep, yep,、
mm-hmm.
yep.
Right.
I like that they're both occasionally wrong, like、yeah. way off base,、uh-huh. and then they help each other kind of course correct. That's what makes、right. them so strong as a couple.、
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's true!And you know he'd do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There we go. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Say it. Say it. Hey, 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 hey. Let her answer for herself.
Yeah.
The High Priestess.
Don't bring that shit up again.
Oh. This isn't the time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, especially him. Like,
yeah, exactly.
What?
そこまで産みたいなら私は反対しない。ただしその決意を一生忘れないで。はい。それで覚悟決めたら二度とうじうじ泣かないで。そんな暗い女が母親じゃ子供がかわいそうだよ。自分の母親を見習いな。I mean
Right, the kid decision part, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nana determined? What?
Okaeri.
開けっぱなしでどこ行ってたんだよ。心配するだろ。ノブとは話すんだ。ごめん。帰ったと思ってた。買い物に行ってたんだよ。飲む。グレープフルーツジュース。あ、しまった。冷やしとけばよかったな。禁煙は柄にもなくストイックなことするから余計他のことで煮詰まるのかも。そうだよ、お前。禁煙なんて大して意味ねえから無理すんな。
Hypocrisy. I'm not about that life.
まずいよ。そろそろ帰るか。始発も出る頃だし。ごめんね、邪魔して。直樹来てたのに。できてんの、直樹と。いや。大丈夫か、ナナ。え?何が?
Thanks for helping me process.
Wow. It's not. You can end up overstepping your bounds and end up pushing.
Yeah.
Something,
Yeah, that could end up happening.
Yeah. Yeah, you're not different enough, you know? God, the way they frame her looking so weak. Pain.
Yeah.
I'm in pain.
No, it really does. Oh, okay. With you. Okay.
Aww. Okay, Nana, we need your reinforcements then coming in hard here.
Yeah, this is, I thought how Junko was after Shoji was bad. Holy shit.
Junko effectively was like, it's too tiring to have to deal with your shit.
Yeah.
So I'm going to...
Holy
I'm going to
shit.
Push you off effectively onto this other person. All right. I okay. thought the last episode or two was
yeah.
rough.
This is
a whole other beast here.
This was. I'm just going to be real upfront with it. This was way too much for me.
Yeah.
Like, oh my God. I still feel dumbfounded.
Sick.
I still feel sick. Like this. Okay. And the thing is, yeah. with the way, like with the track record that the show has displayed, right? Mm-hmm. And everything, it goes into those uncomfortable topics.
Yep.
This is a very real, uncomfortable topic that can be explored, and it's, yeah. I'm sure it's going to be very educational.
Yes.
But holy shit.
It was painful.
Painful, and that's like a...
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know if I want to... I don't know if I can handle that. You know, right? Like,
continue,
like
yeah.
yeah, yeah. Like, yeah. This is... Yeah, red light, you know, like
no, this is like yeah, like uh-huh, I feel uh-huh, violated uh-huh, uh-huh. because what we have in the story here is we have an emotionally manipulative
mm-hmm.
basically an abuser
yeah
getting away
mm-hmm.
with getting into this relationship with Hachi.
Mm-hmm.
Being positioned in such a way that he will dominate her life and emotions and all that
yep.
for the next little bit of the story. One.
Little bit if we're lucky.
No. This is a guaranteed. I'm saying this.
Yeah.
I'm saying only the things that are guaranteed here because it could go any way. But what that means is that, one, we have to watch
mm-hmm.
that.
Yep. And the thing is that the reason why I'm pushing back on the little bit is that this is a complicated enough situation that in order to fully explore, I could totally see it taking a
long time. Of course, but I'm saying guaranteed it will at least
sure.
take
yes.
a little bit of the show
mm-hmm.
before we see any change with it.
Yep.
That's what I'm saying.
Gotcha.
Second,
yeah.
not only do we have to watch it, we have to accept that Junko
mm-hmm.
made this judgment call when Nana or Hachi was in this pliable state here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here's the part that's interesting. There's a possibility that Hachi would have come to this conclusion without Junko's involvement.
Yep, totally possible.
Very possible.
And without Takumi's involvement.
Yes.
Possible.
But that being said, Junko, to say you fumbled this would be an understatement.
This is multiple orders of magnitude
yes.
beyond the situation with Shoji. And that
yes.
makes it so sickeningly ironic, the
yeah.
conversation in the intro where I'm like, hey, that's the way that it could be. That would put me most at ease even more than Yasu. And then you're like, are you sure about that, though? With the kind of, like, you know, they might not be fully equipped. Holy shit.
Yep.
Like, because
yep.
because
I'm
the thing
you,
is...
They warned us.
Yeah,
they warned
yeah,
us
they did.
Like 15
they did.
Episodes ago
and,
when they bucked,
right.
fucked that up.
And here's the situation here, all right?
Yeah.
I am not saying that Nana does not have the... should not have the ability to decide for herself.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
But the
right.
problem is that she's in an incredibly vulnerable situation.
Yeah.
Junko and Kyosuke were made aware of this.
Mm-hmm.
And in that state, it's not just that Junko reached the point where she's like, hey, she believed Nana's resolve, which is a bit short-sighted to say the least, given what you know of Nana. And that's at best, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it's also approaching the situation from her own perspective on what the proper way is for things to go that makes it so
well,
that then all the advice and things that she gives to Nana as far as ways to assess the situation and frame it are basically just pushing her views on Nana, whether that's what she's intending to do or not.
Yeah, yeah. So right now, Junko had like three sections of her conversation
mm-hmm.
here. First part is she's just in shock trying to figure out the facts. Right.
Yeah.
Nana, Haji, is not always good at communicating just the straight facts.
Nope. And especially not now, because she's Takumi's got her claws into her, so, you know.
That's not the point. That's not the point. The point that I'm making is that Junko could have made this decision on improper data. But we see, in the first part of the conversation, not only does she kind of stumble around a bit, but she actually lands pretty bang on right with what the situation is from a factual perspective, but also from an intentions perspective, a little bit with regards to Takumi.
Yep.
Now, second part. She then realizes that Nana wants the baby.
Right.
And there's an unspoken thing that probably because of cultural reasons or many other things, we don't end up having the discussion of whether an abortion is a good idea here. It's just kind of lightly tossed up in, but it's not actually like given a proper discussion surrounding.
And the idea that Nana just viscerally does not want to do that, that's fine.
That's fine.
That's fine.
And I think that's why Junko does that. So, 2 points for Junko so far. This is the point that I think is really important here. There's a pivot. There's a hard pivot in the discussion where she realizes, and this is my interpretation, so it's not necessarily exactly right, but I think she realizes that from Junko brain, it's I can't get through to Nana or to Hachi. I can't actually change her mind here.
She's not listening to me. She's never really listened to me, and this is, you know, kind of as a result of that, right?
Yeah.
And which also is supported by the fact that once then she starts to feel like Hachi might listen with the, this is what you're going to do, then she starts laying into her of like, okay, but do you realize what this decision means, et cetera, et cetera.
Right. And I need to correct a little bit of what I'm saying here. They did have Hachi talking about the idea of abortion and saying, I could never do that. And that is why there's not a discussion. But I feel like if Junko's going to go the like, I'm going to support you, but I'm going to do the, well, then if you've decided this, then you better do this all the way here.
Yeah.
Which feels kind of...
Yeah. Mind if I take this?
Go for it.
So, if you're going to make this decision to have the baby, cool. But the, well, maybe keep going with your thing, because that's related to the thing that I was going to bring up. But basically, Junko has dealt with Nana not being responsible for a long time. It's caused her a bunch of heartache. She has felt like she was the one sort of looking after Hachi, almost mothering her in a way, being that big sister that's always put upon, right? Mm-hmm. Very frustrating and understandably so, right? Yeah. Then, once this happens and Nana basically says, okay, I want the baby, I'm, you know, and yeah, there's not really much that you can do about that. She wants the baby. Okay, there you go. But then it goes into this thing of, okay, so clearly we're not going to see about Nobu helping raise the baby because, oh, I guess it'd crush his dreams, it'd be inconvenient.
All that kind of practical, kind of prediction-based stuff is kind of moot in my point. That's basically the kind of stuff of like, yes, speculatively, there's a likelihood that you're right in some way, so I don't rather... It's too 50-50 for it to matter in my mind. But I think it's when she then shifts to then things being about, but this is where it's your fault, Hachi. This is where you're the one that fucked up here. And basically turns this into a lecture here. And then Kyosuke's like, hey, this is maybe not the time. And she then ends up giving a little bit of a you accusatory kind of lecture here. And she says something that I think on like second looking back at this is a very damning thing to say.
Yep.
Do you really understand that you can't have a normal, happy family with a guy who won't marry you? So,
no.
So
love has nothing to do with it. It's whether or not the certificate is signed so that the ring's on the finger. That's what'll make it a happy family.
Right. This is the part where I give the character the pass for maybe the time that this was written in, and maybe sure. the person that wrote this is even older than the time that they're set in.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
obviously they're older. I meant like they're from a generation where their time when they were this age was even more before this. And but the idea that yes, people all the time have normal, happy families without marriage being involved.
Uh huh.
And while that might not be a thing at this time in Japan or what have you. The idea that then she says, oh, okay, then you better be faithful. You better be prepared when they're not gonna be married right. to like, begin with.
Like, and the thing is, so in the best possible view of this for Junko in my mind,
yeah.
the marriage thing is that she's not talking about emotions. She's talking about practicality and money and a roof overhead and food and all that stuff, right?
Yeah, yeah. Children
are expensive, and Nana and often
Nana has
ignores
no money.
Those things. Well, she doesn't. Right. You're right.
But Nana has been in the I might starve kind of situations like yes. a couple times.
Right.
She's and 20. So, remember.
Right. Like, but the fact yeah. that she says that after that of the you have to be faithful to this guy, it's like what the fuck are you talking about, Junko? Like this, you're. Talking about the practical side of things of, hey, you need to make sure that this is a thing that happens, that's fine. That's good things to talk to her about. Mm-hmm. And theoretically, if you weren't wanting to just sort of get rid of her, then maybe you and Kyosuke would even be like, hey, well, you know, you'll have to do this, but we can try and help out where we can, you know.
Right. And right? that's also part of the thing of where I get the character read that she's kind of giving up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where things come full circle, where she then gives what you get almost a recontextualization of when she's done with the conversation of, hey, even if Takumi becomes the child's guardian, he does all this stuff for the mm-hmm. child support. He ends up kind of like being there for you enough to where it makes the actual raising of the kid doable, like from a practical standpoint.
Sure.
There's no guarantee he'll even feel like love for the kid.
Right.
What she's doing there is actually trying to subtly try and say like, you should really get the divorce. Abortion.
Do you really want to do this to a kid? You know?
Right. Yeah. Right. And so she says, okay, if you want to have it that badly, I won't stop you. As long as you never forget that determination you have. What she's mm-hmm. interpreting that as is that this is now your decision that you need to own. I don't want to deal with yep. the bullshit that I know is coming. Mm-hmm. When you're right. upset that you made this decision. And then they frame this next bit here of, now that you've made that commitment, I don't want to ever see you crying over this.
As she's showing looking her down lower, on her. Yeah,
looking
yeah.
down. Uh-huh.
And the other thing, so once the adding to the giving up part, if Junko actually believed her determination about it, then it wouldn't be the, okay, now you need to do it with Takumi. Then it's the, okay, you're going to have this baby. You're signing up for all the shit show that it's going to be.
Yeah.
So how are you going to have this baby?
Right. Thank you. Like, that's a really great way to frame it. Yeah.
As opposed to what she ends up doing here, where she basically mm-hmm. just continues to reinforce, hey, this guy that we have understood and acknowledged to be all kinds of, at the very least, manipulative, if not abusive and all that stuff, right? Yeah, he's your only option. He's your only option.
Yep.
So get comfortable, right? Like what the fuck? And Kyosuke's right there, and he's not denying any of it, right? That's the part that makes me so distraught over this, is because, like, there's an element of where this feels like it's the times being, like, rearing its ugly head within the story, and yet, because the creator has demonstrated their ability to handle this stuff so well so many times, this could just be the... Yes, this is a realistic response from the time in which this is created. Isn't that fucked, right? You know,
or not even isn't this a realistic response from the time? This is just a realistic response for Junko. I think sure. I think in a lot of ways the show did a really good job of building up the naivete of Hachi.
Yeah.
Specifically in the way that she views Kyosuke and Junko.
Mm-hmm.
They built it up in other ways as well, but I'm going to explore this one.
Sure.
Hachi came to them because they are her oldest friends in that yep. regard.
Mm-hmm.
So by the nature of convenience, she can cry in front of them. She can talk mm-hmm. openly. She can also kind of disconnect herself from that situation. So it works on many levels. So yep. I would say good plus Nana or mm-hmm. Hachi, you ended up actually going to people that would be good to process this out with.
Yeah.
But... you didn't take account for what kind of boundaries you were going to set when you went in to have this conversation. And I can't hold you entirely blameless in that regard here. That is something where when people come in and are emotionally vulnerable and are wanting to process out some things here,
That's almost defined by the fact that there are boundaries that aren't up because they aren't capable of it or whatever.
So setting maybe not necessarily like that they need to know what they are like telepathically or anything like that. And not even that you need to say some like hard details here, but basically just saying like, hey, I really just need to commiserate and just process this out with all y'all.
Sure.
But then when she starts to lecture you, being like, hey, yeah, I'll figure this out, but like...
Right, can we just go back to, you know, dealing with the feelings first, you know?
Right. And that's the tough part here, is that she actually really does want their insight here, because she is young.
She knows she's naive.
That she's naive, immature. Uh-huh. But, and this is the frustrating thing here, is that she came in here with a decision already made with regards to having the child.
Yep.
If I put myself into Junko's position, there is something that must feel so alien to Hachi. Mm-hmm. Like, the idea of my internal perspective of who she is.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense that she wants to have this baby.
Right.
Except I know that she wants to be that classic housewife kind of thing here. But in the other picture of being someone that also kind of runs away from her problems, doesn't directly face things, tries to get other people to kind of solve her problems for her, that feels like she would then want the abortion. So the idea that she didn't do that, Junko didn't push that, Junko misunderstood that Hachi has, like, must have tons of determination to be able to do this, because from Junko's perspective, they've probably had many times with, you know, her and Kyosuke of like, so are we going to have a kid? And they're like, hell no. That's a whole other world. But it's then the assumption that she's wise enough to be able to know what she's taking on here.
Right. As opposed to what is actually going on, which is Nana is running away again. And looking to someone else to save her in the whole Takumi situation.
And then you pushed choosing... her to Takumi.
Yeah, right.
Like, that's where you fumbled fucking hard.
Like, you reinforced her own negative self-esteem that, yes, has reasons for being there, but that doesn't mean you need to do that.
Right.
That, oh my God, I'm aware of my inadequacies, and this is kind of a really shitty time to have to deal with all of that. And you're like, yes, you are inadequate. You do need someone to save you. And you can't ask to anyone else, even though he's literally like the last option ever, right?
This is something where, like, you know, when you're like, the villain's plan is this, but like, if you put a 5-year-old into it, you break it up. Here you go. So I understand taking Takumi's money. Like, I understand it here.
Yeah.
I understand it here. What the fuck does taking his money have to do with a relationship with him?
Right.
It's nothing.
It's whole court thing ordered.
Where it might be a Japan thing. He actually doesn't owe her any child support. That might
possibly
be,
like, but even then, like, the idea, like, they were talking about the
probably
idea
probably legally that, yet he does not, but they would have to do a they would have to do a thing in order to
but
get
even
that.
Then they were talking about it from the standpoint of, and this is why I'm pissed at Junko even before she gives up on Hachi, is that when she's talking about the he'll only give you child support, right, she's continuing to reinforce the idea that it's something that he needs to fix, right, and that he is the one that to go to fix it, as opposed to he pays child support, but okay, just because the thing that she could have gotten at is, just because the money and stuff is covered, raising a baby is still going to be a whole hell of a thing, right?
She did get into that, and I think this is the point here, is that she's doing this to try and dissuade her from having the baby. She's saying all this, he's going to be, you know...
No, right. But she still frames it from the standpoint of, you know, he's not going to marry you, yada, 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 right? Like, that's... Because, it's going from the standpoint of not trying to have the baby, and so...
Right. She's trying to attack the idea that you won't have your charming little housewife life that you imagine we'll have here. And that's why she thinks... Because she's framed it as... If she wants to have the baby this much, this dream of being the housewife is overriding all of the usual common sense and Hachi flaws over here that would have her having the abortion.
Uh-huh.
But because of that, she's like, is it really actually that strong? Does she really care more about the baby than being with this shitty guy? Well, then fine. You deserve him. Either way, it's still fucked because she keeps pushing the idea that she should be with him versus the mm-hmm. idea of what I think is just extremely simple and logical. Yeah, take that fucker. If you say he has money,
take the money.
Court order his child support and then never see him again.
Yeah.
Raise the kid. It's gonna suck.
Uh-huh.
But you'll have his support with the money. It'll be court ordered.
Maybe
then, then you can help.
Go back to your parents and be like, hey, shit, I need help.
Right.
You call me terrible for having a child out of wedlock or whatever. I just need a place to stay to help make the things work as I raise
and
it.
That's where I think this comes into the cultural thing mm-hmm. as well, is that's the idea that...
It's still shame-based.
It's shame, yeah.
Yeah.
And like, so most cultures shame women.
Yeah.
In some way, shape, or another. I will not say all because I don't know every single
You're
culture.
Right.
But the extent to uh-huh. the way that they do it sometimes
is ridiculous.
This.
And the thing is, yeah, and getting educated about that, and not shying away from that, because that is something that happens, and it happens a lot more than people would think and everything. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah, it happens everywhere. Yeah.
I don't want to signing up for the road of drama and, you know, band mishaps and yes, all of the painful stumbles and bumps and everything along the way. Mm-hmm. Sure, as these characters try and figure things out and grow. But I don't want to sign up for this. Mm. I don't, what?
Yeah.
No.
And that's why I think we need to let this show cook a little bit. There's going to be other opinions coming in from Nana at the very end of the episode.
Yeah.
She says, I'm going to be the manga heroine that's too perfect to be real, that's going to support you no matter what.
Yep.
And then she's going to be like, I'm going to have Takumi's baby,
and we're getting married.
And she's going to be like, I do not give my blessing. Fuck that is bullshit.
Right. Like,
in some ways, Nana's own possessiveness is going to come out in a mm-hmm. way that might be helpful.
Yo, sure. I want there to be a full-on thing where, like, I mean, this is not going to happen, and that's unfortunate, right? Because certainly if you're bringing up a topic like this, you have to commit to it, right? To show the way in which it, you know.
You don't have to commit to it that long.
Well, okay, you don't have to commit to it that long. But, like, but you know, what I would love to have happen is everybody starts to hear about what happens, and, you know, the words get around to some sensible heads, because there are some in this show somewhere, right? And then Nana shows up. Right. And then Nana shows up to the next band practice, and there's just an intervention poster, you know, right, like banner hanging from the ceiling.
Fucking Shin's gonna be like,
yeah,
what? That ain't it.
What
that
the
ain't
fuck?
It, Hachi.
Like, yeah, like, I'm 15 and I'm...
Like, I'll take responsibility.
I'm 15 getting fucked by grown adults. Yeah, yeah. And I know that's bad.
Yeah.
Right, like...
Right, it's the kind of thing where I would love almost the show to... Give us some lighthearted comedy almost immediately after that in this episode of other characters just being like, so we're going to co-raise this baby with as a band, right? That's what we're going to do. We're all going to be the father.
Yeah, like...
And then they come to her and they're gonna be like, so congratulations on having a baby. You're going to mm-hmm. be a mom. That's awesome.
Yep.
We would all like you to check out this option here of when we debut... Your baby will be, you know...
We will hold it up like Simba from Pride Rock.
No. We will financially dedicate a portion of our mm-hmm. band stuff to make sure that you don't have to get this fucking asshole any more into your life than he already is.
Right. Like you could absolutely have something where it's like the... they say all of this stuff. She wakes up from the bad dream of, oh, fuck, I thought this is what I had to do. And then they look at the camera. Everyone turns and looks at the camera and is like, yeah, that'd be really fucked if, you know.
Yeah, but that's not this kind of show.
No, it's not that kind of show.
Yeah.
And so now I'm just sick to my stomach, being physically sick to my stomach, like, oh, my God.
Right.
All right, this is what the show's telling us to get ready for.
Right. My hope is that we actually genuinely explore it for around 5 episodes at least. I think that it's important that it gets explored for a little bit.
Yeah.
But I hope that at least 5 episodes before this show ends, because remember, you know,
mm-hmm.
this is an anime of a manga that
the manga didn't finish, and the anime probably, I'm guessing, then didn't catch up to the manga.
No, definitely
you know,
not. So right? I would hope that things get sundered there for any number of reasons.
Sure.
Don't really care what the reason is, but I want the hard road, specifically where Hachi does have the baby,
mm-hmm.
and it is something that the band helps her raise yeah. together.
Go into
because
just how hard
fuck
it is.
Yeah, the found family uh-huh. is too damn real in this show.
Right.
I want all these band members in their own flaws and their own mm-hmm. dysfunction or what have you to be the awkward aunts and uncles
everybody
for this child.
Stop smoking. They're like, okay, yes. all right, that's it. You know, they all have withdrawal Wednesday, you know, where they like, you know, just group up together and shiver, you know, at like an apartment or something. Right. You know, like that's,
yeah.
And also the bit that was so I'm so glad it was brought up, and yet then it's like, wait, nothing was done with it, of the Kyosuke being like, no, it, like Junko talking about proof that she didn't like she wasn't sleeping with Takumi or whatever, and it's like, okay, first off, that's if you ever get to the point where you need proof in a relationship, the relationship's over.
I will say this is the part that's really sad. Cheating is so normalized as like that's a thing people do nowadays. Mm-hmm. That people will willingly put up cameras in their own house.
Yeah.
And convince the other person that, like, no, this is good for us.
Yeah, no.
Person agrees.
No, I know. Yes, not that the relationship actually ends, but, what the fuck are you doing? The relationship should end.
But I'm just saying that's.
But then, yeah. No, I.
You're not a stand-in for everyone's reality.
No, I know.
The amount of people I've heard where it's just like, oh yeah.
Yeah.
Like they're probably cheating.
Right. But then.
But
even,
I don't know.
Then even after that, Kyosuke, one of the few times he was allowed to speak some sense in this episode.
Well, he also was kind of dumb a couple times.
He was pretty dumb a couple times. Like he would, like his defining characteristic almost, you know, like up until now in the show, is that he was always chill and always kind of knew when to shut up and knew what to say when there was something.
I think this was one of those moments as well where he opened up with the like, just letting it know, I'm really awkward right now. And they're like, why are you feeling uncomfortable?
Yeah, right. Like he's communicating his feelings regarding the situation so that way he can better, like, you know, integrate with whatever's going on. But then he's like, hey,
yeah,
it's not about proof.
No.
It's about the, you know,
showing that you care.
Showing that you care. And that's it.
That's
right?
It. Yeah.
Like that's all that's needed. And then guess what? Like didn't happen. Like,
yeah.
It's literally like being spelled out for the characters. Hey, that's fine. Just communicate. Just we're literally telling you what to say.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
And they don't say it. And it's not even focused on as like a, and then she decides not to. It's just not in the episode.
Nope.
Maybe that'll be gotten into in the very next episode when she decides, oh yeah, I didn't cheat on him, and I'm breaking up with you, and I'm marrying him, and he's going to raise the baby and all that stuff. And I made this decision entirely without, you know, talking about any of my feelings regarding this to you. Not one word.
Nope.
Not one word.
Yep.
Yes, Nana, you're right in saying that you're shitty for treating Nobu this way. But just because you treat someone shitty one time or even multiple times, or you are a shitty person one time or multiple times, does not mean that you are beholden to continue in that behavior.
Yep.
Holy shit. And then
there's so much shame.
And then Junko and Kyosuke's conversation after they go their separate ways, and their whole like...
Well, because they don't understand. They don't understand.
Yeah.
They're lost in the sauce. The idea is that they're saying that, okay, so right now, you know.
Yeah.
I think she really, I wonder if she really plans to have it, because they don't necessarily believe in that. Sure. So that's why they were trying to persuade her.
Uh-huh.
So then it's the, like, I'm so worried I'm getting a stomachache, but if Nana came to that decision herself, so really don't have the right to interfere. They're talking about the baby part, not the other part. Best we can do just now is support her. I guess you're right. That is really the best thing you can do, honestly.
Yeah, it's, but, so it sure would have been great if you, like, said that that
or
was...
Or you did that only for this whole thing here. Just shut up and let her talk.
Yeah.
Like, so hold on here.
Mm-hmm.
She then brings up the dream. She has an abortion. Things go well with Nobu. Her dream might come about. She sacrificed another baby. She's really determined. He makes the joke. Why won't Takumi take Nana as his wife? And probably because Nana's harder to take care of than a child. And there's the point at which I kind of solidified that idea in my head that Junko kind of gave up on Nana and just...
But even then, I feel like with the way that they're talking about it from the perspective in their own minds that it would be fixed if Takumi...
Well,
just
yes,
married her.
Because they don't understand. That's why
I'm saying. But they'd already been laid out, and they acknowledged that, like, oh, this guy's shitty.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Like it's the kind of thing where it's like, hey, if you do a, you know, you do a modern retelling of Pride and Prejudice, maybe don't have Lydia end up with Wickham because, yeah, you got what you deserved, or that's the happy ending or whatever. Because it's like, no, family should go rescue her. And be like, all right, we'll figure this out. But
again, that's the point of those kinds of stories, is that culturally it was the right thing for Wickham to do, to marry her there.
Right.
Yes.
And seeing that in a period piece for, you know, hundreds of years ago is one thing. Seeing that in a...
Well, that's the point.
20
that's
years ago.
That's why this is educational. This
yeah,
is the
yeah
point.
I know. I don't have to like it. It's... Yeah.
Yeah. Oh. But yeah, Yasu gives a meaningful listening hand
to Nana.
To Nana. And
I now... loved that. I loved that so much. Like the doorbell, you know, or you know, he answers the phone and then he just hears her voice. There's like the lightning thing that goes across the screen and he's there. That was awesome.
Yeah. I don't know if we actually talked about Takumi's actual like thing that he did here, because we spent a lot of time before we did this discussion just talking about this episode and how we were going to discuss it, but like the fact that he does all the manipulation things again to set up the not only am I going to marry you, which is I know is going to shock you because there's reason for me to.
I will condescend to do that as a treat, little puppy, for doing what I wanted you to do.
Yes.
So now you're happy now, right? You'll be a good, obedient little servant.
But that's after she says, you know, I want you to raise, you know, this baby with me. Yeah, I want to have this baby and raise it as your child. Yeah. And then he just kind of has that, like, almost like, what? Like, I think he was genuinely a little bit surprised that she quickly decided.
Absolutely. Well, and I think that's why he says want to get married, because he realizes that's what she wants, and so he's like, I have to reinforce this behavior, because I didn't think I was getting this. I thought this was going to be a lot harder of a battle to fight here to get her fully under my thumb. And oh, she just submits to me. Oh, okay, cool. So stay that way.
Yeah. But that's where we're at, y'all.
And I am really appreciative that with the way that the shot was framed there, Nana was made to look small and weak in that moment as just that little bit of a like reassuring of like, yeah, this is bad. You know, Nana thinks that this is good, but you know.
Yeah. And it's depressing for us because we have to wait till next episode to find out what happens next.
But I think she's going to do it, right? Like after
well,
all
I'm
this...
talking, I don't care about what she's going to do. I'm talking about how everybody else is going to respond. I'm looking at their other main character in here
who's
resolving to do a specific thing here.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see what Nana's going to do.
Yeah.
I've already seen what she's decided to do here.
Uh-huh.
I want to see what Nana's going to do.
Because
I want to see how this affects the band. I want to see how this brings everybody either closer or ends up creating some dividing lines.
Mm-hmm.
There's some really fun things that can come into the family is thicker than blood
kind
of situation here. And then also the actual family stuff that could come into play here, which might be really interesting too.
Yeah.
But all that to say, y'all, thank you so much for watching this episode's reaction and very painful discussion. Mm-hmm. If you want to see the next episode's reaction and discussion right now, though, go check out the link in the description below for our Patreon and get on early access. There you can watch full-length timer reactions there, and all this comes with Discord access, so you can chat with us in the community there about this show, about anime in general, and also be sure to check out our Twitch channel. So yeah, if any of that interests you, we'll see you there. But until then, we're Semblance of Sanity. I'm Caleb.
I'm Jacob.
And we'll see you all next time.